Welcome to the Hack GVSU Hackathon in 2018. This video is going to demonstrate how to develop programs for the REST API category of the hackathon. Now, we do have explanation of the two categories, the basic HTML and then the advanced REST API under Hack GVSU Frequently Asked Questions. And on the day of the hackathon, we are going to have in-person training that's going to help you to understand this material deeper. So let's start with running our own Blackboard Learn system. We can do that with the Amazon Web Services Marketplace, and I have one installed, and we'll use that for this demo. In an earlier video, I showed you how to integrate simple HTML apps and widgets into the Blackboard Learn system, and this is going to be the first category of the hackathon. So now, in the advanced category, we want to use REST API in order to access deep data inside of Blackboard Learn. So we'll have access to student information, to course information, and we'll be able to innovate and to develop apps with this data. So having Blackboard Learn running is the first step. Now the next step is to have your own web server running. This does not have to be expensive. In fact, for students, it is often free. For example, the Amazon Web Services Cloud 9 system provides students with free accounts and makes that very flexible. You can use other web hosting systems like the 1&1, where at $5 per month, you can actually have your own virtual server where you have control over all your web service settings. Finally, the Amazon Web Services Elastic Beanstalk is another great option for free development of REST API services. All right, at this point then, I have a server running and I am logged in. This is running Apache and PHP. Now, if you were just getting started, you might want to read up a little bit about the API, and Blackboard provides some resources on the community.blackboard.com website, and this includes also demo code. So if we were to look for a demo of REST API, we'll see that there are options in other languages in addition to PHP. For this demonstration and for this video, I am going to use an application already developed with the PHP demo code that was provided by Blackboard. Now, this complete application is available for download on my GitHub account, and it's called Course Games. So let's get started. We will get started by downloading this application. It will come as a zip file, and the next step will be to unzip it onto your server. I have done so. So my application is in the htdocs directory of the Apache server, and course games is the folder. So here we see index.php, get data, and then classes directory. All these came from GitHub from the zip file that we downloaded. To verify that the application was downloaded correctly, we can go ahead and execute it. As you can see, I have my URL with just a free domain. If you are running off a specific IP address, you don't have to purchase a domain. Just navigate to noip.com and you will be able to buy or you'll be able to configure a domain. Then if you'd like to run SSL, you can use the free Let's Encrypt SSL certificates to give you a really clean access to your application. But if you're accessing it via an IP address and HTTP only, that's fine as well. So this is what the application should look like without any configuration, without any additional modification of code. Our next step then is going to be to add this application to Blackboard Learn. How do we do that? Well, this application is going to be an interactive application with the user, so we will be using LTI. Now, LTI happens to be Learning Technology Interoperability Standard, which provides a set of variables that will be returned to our application from the learning management system, in this instance, Blackboard Learn. Therefore, we'll be able to know who the user is who clicked on the button, and then we'll be able to have context as their course, for example. At this point, let's go ahead and configure this inside of a course. So we'll navigate to a sample course. I have this problem solving using spreadsheet online content developed. And so within this course, we'll go ahead and create a new content area. We'll call this Hack GVSU and submit. Now this likely created at the bottom, so let's move it up to the top. And at this point, this will be our canvas for creating the user interface to the application that we just installed. I'm going to copy the URL to my application, and next we'll go to build content, and then we'll use a web link. Now this web link is something that Blackboard creates dynamically, and it's not actually a link as we know it by just clicking on it. This is going to create a post form in the background, which is part of that LTI standard. So at this point, I'm going to maybe call this course games, and we'll put our URL in. And then the key is to select this link is to a tool provider. So, what is a tool provider? Well, tool provider happens to be an external application which was approved by the Blackboard administrator. And we are then able to share information with that external application. So, where is this tool provider created? Well, this tool provider is created under System Admin. And this is the administrator panel for Blackboard Learn. And then we need to find building blocks link, and then LTI tool providers. Now this screen allows us to create approvals, basically, to work with a specific interactive, so LTI for just passing interactive information with an external application. And so I configured my application right here. I can go to edit, and I have my domain name approved. I then set some of the licensing, which of course in my application I am not checking for it, but something we could license, and then we are happy to send over data in this development environment. Okay, so let's return to my link. I will go ahead and press submit. At this point in time, the Blackboard application is configured. So if we were to share this application with another school, this is what the Blackboard administrator would do. They would create a place in the course. They would then create an LTI link. Then all the REST API is still coming up. So we have not done much of the REST API integration at this point. So at this point, let's go ahead and launch our application as it is. I'll go ahead and click on the link. The post form is created, and now we are at our remote server where LTI information was passed. Now we expected some errors because we didn't configure our course games application, the REST application yet. So this is exactly what we would expect. But the communication took place from Blackboard down to our application. So let's take the next step. And if we were to review the instructions in GitHub, so far we configured the LTI part with the LTI providers, and now we are going to go ahead and create the REST API application ID, and we'll work with the REST API. All right, so to get started, we actually need to navigate to developer.blackboard.com. In order to work with REST API, we have to register ourselves as a developer and then create a key and secret which will identify us to those who host Blackboard applications, and it'll give us an opportunity to have their permission. This website does allow us to explore the API, and so you can see the different options that we have within REST API, but that's coming up next. Let's go ahead and start with the My Apps link, and let's register our first application. I'm going to go ahead and call that Hack GVSU app, and this is my first app. Let's go ahead and press save. Now, at this point, we have application key and secret. We need to take a note of it because they will not be displayed to us again. The application key will be, but not the secret. So if we were to put it perhaps in a Word document or somewhere, it's very important to store those. Now, sure, we can regenerate new ones, and that's not a big deal. But if we click continue, it will not be available to us again. So let's go ahead and use them. Now, instead of writing them down, I will go ahead and plug them into the application where they're supposed to be. At this point, let's go to our server where we downloaded the GitHub code, and we will be editing a file in the classes directory. Let's go ahead and edit the file. The file is called constants. And so let's jump into this file. Here we're going to look for the key variable, and our application key is the very key that the code is looking for here. So here we go. I pasted in this value, and we'll go ahead and put in the secret. If you are security-minded and privacy-minded, perhaps you're worried that we are posting this video publicly with a key and secret. So after recording this, I will delete this app, and so of course this key and secret will not be useful. So you do have to replace them with your own. All right, at this point, let's go ahead and save this file and quit the editor. Now we are ready to press continue. Notice that the application ID that we were given a moment ago, this application ID is different from the application ID that we see on the main screen. This application ID happens to be a public application ID that we can give away to various organizations, because this is how we are now identified as a developer or a company, and we need permission from the school's Blackboard administrator to include our integration. Let's see how this is done in Blackboard. So now we are back. Let's go back to the system admin panel where we work with the LTI link. Remember, LTI is under building blocks. Now REST API. So at this point, we have the application ID and the user, which actually grants us access into Blackboard Learn configured. We'll go ahead and press submit. So now let's go ahead and test this application as a student. We'll go ahead and click on the switch to student view. And now I am a student. I'll go ahead and click on the link. And notice that my student user now has a score attached. In previous view, the instructor didn't have any data because the instructor doesn't have a grade. But now I have some data associated with me. We can now test further the application by clicking on Change Instructor. This, of course, is to simulate the different grade that perhaps I would have with a new instructor. And then we can also add a new semester to show what my grade would be in a future semester. As we do that, the code automatically changes also the table, which is there for accessibility. So a screen reader would be able to read the updates as they are happening. So this is a quick walkthrough arranging the REST API integration between Blackboard Learn and our own web server, and then using REST API. So just to review, we need to have our own hosted system our own application. And so as you can see, I am running my own server here. Then we need to have some code on this server which is going to use REST API to connect to Blackboard. And then as we test, we would have an interactive link to our server, and then the link sends the post request. Out of the link, we can figure out perhaps what is the application calling, and then who the user is that clicked on the link. This allows our server to connect back to Blackboard and pull data out and then present it to the user. It is not impossible to create REST API integrations without LTI. So once we were given permission under sysadmin, our application was approved, we could run simply on our server altogether. This would be without the context, so we would not know perhaps who is right now logged into Blackboard, but we could pull data out of Blackboard Learn to say, for example, today at GVSU there are 57 A grades and there are 2 Fs posted in the Blackboard system. And so this we could do at any time by just pulling grades and then displaying information to the end user. So hopefully this walkthrough was helpful in learning a little bit more about REST API, but really you can take the web design and web development skills that perhaps you have learned in introductory courses and then turn them into enterprise app development, and feel free to use our demo code, which has some code running and data coming in, and then your ability to perhaps start modifying that code into something new. Thank you and have fun at HackGVSU.